In this video, I'm going to show you how to pull data from another file in Excel based on a criteria. So I'll be using this source file. Obviously, you can use any source file you want. There are a couple of things I need to mention about your source file. So there are a couple of ways to go about this. If your source file is laid out like this, so you have your headers in the first row and your data goes row by row like this, then really nothing else you have to do in the source file. You could just use it as is. However, if you have situations when your tables are, I don't know, like this in the middle of the spreadsheet, and then you have a bunch of other things here, etc., maybe another table, then in that case, you want to make sure that you take the source data in your source file, whatever you have here, and convert it to a table. So you'll go under Insert and click Table, and then click My Table Has Headers, which refers to the first row in this, press OK, and that's going to convert this to a table. And then you want to go on top here, table design. Now, if you hate this design, you can go in here and remove that none to get rid of that design. You can also keep it. But the main thing you want to worry about here is just name this table here on the left. So just name it anything you want, no special characters, no spaces. So you could just call this people or something. It doesn't matter. Just remember what you call this. Now, in my case, I'm not gonna do this. I'm just gonna not save any of the stuff I did. And I'm just gonna use the source file, which didn't have any extra rows or columns or anything. You wanna make sure you close the source file before you start doing this. So I have the other file closed. Now I have my new file. In this file, I want to basically pull some information based on criteria. And what I'm gonna do, actually, let's bring that file back for 1 second so I can explain you what I'm going to do here. So I'm going to just take this gender column and I'm going to pull just, let's say, female customers from this list. Again, you could use any criteria you want. I'm going to go with that. By the way, this has a column name missing, so you probably don't want that happening. So make sure you have some unique column names, but I'm going to leave that as is to see how Excel deals with that anyways, just for testing. So now I'm gonna go to my new file where I need to pull that data. Go to data section right here on top, and under data section, I'm gonna go get data and then do from file and then from workbook. And at this point, I'm gonna just pick that file. This was that file I just had open. Hit import, and this is what we're gonna get on our screen. So as you can see, we get this pop-up. So what this is gonna show you, it's gonna show you all the tabs that exist in that Excel file. It would also show you all the tables. So if you had that second case that I've mentioned, at this point, you would just click on that table name in this list as a source. In my case, I'm just gonna choose the worksheet, this one. It should give us a little preview right in here. And then I'm going to click on this transform data. In older versions of Power Query, this may be called like edit or something. So if that's the case, just click on that. So basically, you're going to get this window where we can basically do some transformations on this data. And all I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna go to this gender column, open the filter, and just pick female, press OK. And you should see how that filters to just female. And at this point, I can do close and load and close and load. And that's gonna create another worksheet in this file, and it's only gonna pull female, let's call them clients in this case, from that list. So if you make updates to your original file, then what you want to do, you want to just click on this refresh on the right. And if you have new records, it will basically just pull them and you would get them in this table again. Another thing to remember, if you close this on the right and you want to get that back, you can get it back by going under data. And under data, you have this queries and connections, and that's where it is. So that's that for a simple thing like that. So you could obviously filter by more columns if you wanted to, but I want to get this a little more interesting. So let's say we want to have some sort of option here when we select whether we want to pull female or male customers. And based on that selection, we'll pull the data from that other file. So to do something like that, let me just first create some space above this. And what I'll do, I'll just have a dedicated cell. I'll call it gender. So you want to make sure you have some sort of name on top here because we need to create a table out of this. And for this to be a table, it needs a column name. And just below, we'll have the option. So let's say we want to choose male this time. So I'm going to take this and I want to use that in my queries somehow. And to do that, I'm going to need to convert this to a table. So I'll select this, go under insert, click on table, and check this. My data has headers, my table, press OK. And we want to make sure we go here under design. You can choose a different design. You can also remove it, as I said before. I'll pick this one. And we want to make sure we give this table a good name because right now it's called table 2. So I'm just going to call this our choice. Now to use this table, I'm going to click on this, go to data section again, and under data section, I'm going to click from sheet. If you don't have it here for whatever reason, you should be able to get it by going under get data. And here you should have that option. I don't know, where is it? There it is, from other sources. See, we have from sheet. And that will be the same thing. So what that's gonna do, it's gonna create another connection to that second table. See, we have this first connection to customers table, and then we have this second connection to this new table. Now, I wanna be able to use this value in this table that says male in this filter right in here. And to be able to do that, first, I'm gonna go back to this table, and I'm gonna convert this to a function. So to do that, I'm just gonna right-click on this name on the left and do create function. Now you'll see it says there are no parameters. That's fine for us. We're gonna create the function anyways. And it's gonna ask, what do you want this new function to be called? I'm gonna call this getChoice. You can call it literally anything you want. Just no spaces, no special characters, and make sure you remember this name because you're gonna need this. So I'm gonna press OK, and this is gonna be now that function. Now the problem with this function is gonna be when we execute this function, if I go back to this table, it's basically gonna give us a table instead of giving us a single value. Now, before we get into modifying that, let's actually go back and use this function on this table to see what happens. So this is a table we had originally. So I'm gonna take this customers table, which is currently filtered to female, go on top here to this advanced editor. And right in here, if you look through all these lines, there is gonna be one line that shows us that filter. See, it says in gender column, we wanna basically filter it to female in quotes. So I'm gonna remove that female that's hard coded in quotes and replace it by that get choice, which is that function that I've created. And because it's a function, I have to have open close parentheses like that. So I'm replacing that hard-coded value with this function that should go and pull the gender. So I'm going to do that and hit done. And you'll see this doesn't work. It says this table is empty. And the reason, like I said, is because instead of getting a single value, because if you remember, it wanted something that says like male or female, what we actually get is this table, which has like a column header and the value below from this function getChoice. Now I'm gonna go to that getChoice function and we're gonna modify that function so it only returns that single value. So I'm gonna click on this getChoice and we're gonna go here on top under advanced editor for the function this time. I'm gonna hit OK. Now what we're gonna do here, we're gonna add another step in this code of this function. So far what we're doing, this last step, we're getting this table results in here in this value or variable they have here. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna add another step. I'm gonna add a comma because each one of the steps, for some reason, they decided to choose a comma as a separator. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna create a new variable where we're gonna store new results. I'm just gonna call it RES for results. And I'm gonna make it equal to, so I'm gonna take this table object in Excel, and here there is gonna be this option, first value. Now, if you're in a newer version of Power Query, this autocomplete works. If you're in an older version, you may need to just type this in because you might not have this autocomplete. So I'm gonna take first value. So what this is doing, it's gonna get us the first value from that table. And the table we need to pass is this table right here, whatever this name is in the line above before the equal sign. So I'm gonna just copy that, paste it right between those quotes over here. And finally, we wanna make sure that when we get this value, we return just that value. So this in, instead of using this variable name they have, we're gonna replace it with our new RES variable that we've created here, which is gonna get us basically the value. So at this point, I'm gonna hit done. And that should modify the function. So let's go back to customers and see what happens. So as you can see, now we get mail only because our function now actually works and returns the right information. So at this point, I'm done with this. We did modify everything we had to. So we're gonna open this, close and load, and we're gonna close and load too. And I'm only gonna create a connection. So the reason for that is none of the newer things we did needs to be displayed in the spreadsheet. Whatever that needs to be displayed is already here. So I'm just gonna only create a connection, press okay. And if you look here, now we just get mail in this list. So that's now based on this value. If I go and update this to female, and we go here and refresh this customers thing, see, it's gonna get us all female values. If we do some random thing and we reload, there's nothing because nothing matches this criteria. So I'll just return this, reload, and now we have all the male clients, just like that. So finally, if you wanted this to be more user-friendly, maybe you want a button here that people can basically click on and get the values. And here you can also make a drop-down to have like male and female options here. You could do that too. So to do something like that, let's start with a drop-down here. I'm gonna click in this cell, go to data here on top, go to data validation, and we're gonna do a list. And right here as a source, I'm just gonna do male comma female, no spaces between these options. And make sure you type that correctly. You can also do this validation from a source sheet if you wanted to. I'm gonna leave that up to you. It's just a drop-down list validation. So there it is. Now I'm gonna have two options here, male and female. And finally, I want the button here that does this reloading, because if somebody doesn't know how to do this, we might want to have like a nicer button for them over here. And to do that, I'm just gonna do a macro. So we're gonna go to developer tab here. And if you don't have this, you can always activate it under file, options. And if you go to customize ribbon, see there's this checkbox for developer. Now for me, that's already active. I don't have to do that. So we're gonna go to this developer tab and we're gonna click record macro. And we're gonna name this something. So I'm gonna call this reload data. Again, no spaces or special characters here. I wanna make sure I save this in this current workbook. So if this is under like personal or something, make sure you switch to this workbook, press okay. And all I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna click on this refresh button. So that's gonna record that action of refreshing. So we'll just stop this recording. And now we should have a macro under this macros to reload data. So at this point, I can just go under insert add a button here. See this first one? And we'll click on that macro I've just recorded to reload the data. Press OK. I'm going to right click and add a text. And we'll just call this pool data or something. So I'm going to right click on this. If you want to move this or something, make sure you right click. Otherwise, left click is going to run the macro. We can resize this. I don't know, whatever you have to do. So finally, now I should be able to close this thing. And if we go here and choose female, click on pool data. See, that does that. Male, that does that. If you want to remove this filter from this gender column, you can go under data, remove the filter out of there. But this should work just fine. And there it is. Now we're pulling the data from the other spreadsheet based on our value here in the sheet. You can also delete this other worksheet if you don't need it. And finally, since we have that recorded macro in this particular worksheet, when you go to save this file, make sure you save it as macro enabled workbook to make sure that button for pulling the refresh works. If you don't want this to be macro enabled workbook, then you probably don't want that button. So just go in here and call it pull data from other file. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.